The application of prescribed fire to manage natural resources utilizes a number of specialized tools and equipment, from protective clothing to hand tools and vehicles. Let's learn about a few of these from some experienced burn managers at a prescribed fire at Trailateer State Forest in southern Illinois.
Hi, my name is Jesse Reichman. I'm the coordinator for the Southern Illinois Prescribed Burn Association. And just want to mention fire protective clothing for prescribed burns and wildfires alike. It's the same type of personal protective equipment, or PPE, as they say. Typically, you've got the usual hard hat and leather gloves. Okay, that's very important. Eye protection, obviously, and leather boots, non-synthetic. They can either be waterproof or not, and they don't have to be steel toe, but leather boots are a must. But other than that, what you're mostly going to see on the fire line is fire-resistant clothing. So these pants here are kind of just a normal, typical khaki, non-rip, fire-resistant cloth. And there's several different brand names that use that fire-resistant material, but all of them are acceptable on the fire line. Same goes for the shirt. There's several different brands that encompass that, but it's all acceptable on the fire line as long as it's a fire-resistant, NFPA-approved clothing. So, also, I'll mention, a lot of times it's a cold morning or a cold day on some of these fires. They also make fleeces that are fire-resistant and other types of outerwear that are also made of that fire-resistant material.
Anything about the color? Like, are they mostly?
Yeah, so typically these start off being really bright yellow and then fade over the years as they get used and abused, but it helps with visibility, so you can kind of tell where your crew members are out in the woods. The pants come in all different colors. We've seen blue, brown, black, you know, yellow, and that just a lot of times depends on where you found them, where you sourced them from, and what agency you're working with. But typically a yellow shirt is standard. And I'm going to show you a few hand tools that are used on the fire line today. So even with all the advances that we've made in the wildfire industry with, you know, water pumps and ATVs and UTVs and all the technical stuff that we have at our disposal, we're still pretty reliant on hand tools. And they get used every day on the fire line, no matter how many other neat trinkets you've got. And one of the interesting things is that these hand tools haven't really changed that much over the years. We're pretty much using the same tools, and they look very similar, and in some cases are probably the same tools that our, you know, forefathers used 100 years ago when they were putting out fires in national forests. And a lot of them are based on agricultural implements, which is really interesting. And they still tend to be some of the most effective things out there. So an example is the flapper. Essentially, it's just a mud flap off of a truck, you know, bolted to the end of a rake handle. And it's simply used to sort of smear out a fire, particularly in grass, they work really well, just by starving the oxygen, just by kind of moving it like this over the fire. Still works so well that they haven't changed the design over all these years. And this one may be an original because it's completely worn out. Another interesting tool is things like this. You know, it's kind of looks like a hoe. A lot of times they take different shapes and forms, but essentially it's an agricultural disc cut out into the shape of a hoe and then welded to the end of a piece of pipe. Insert your post hole digger handle and you've got yourself a fire hoe. And these things are great for digging out, grubbing out burning roots and stumps and things like that, and for digging fire line. And again, just an agricultural tool. And it's been used for, you know, decades and decades on the fire line. Here's another example. It's called a Pulaski. And it's essentially just a rake, it's essentially like an axe, almost looks like a double-bitted axe, but they've gone and twisted one end of this axe 90 degrees so that it has kind of a hoe function on one side. So it's a great combination tool. If you got to chop and use an axe, you know, to split some logs or something, and then on the other hand, you can do a little digging and dig some fire line with it. Really popular tool on the fire line. You know, it's decades old, and you'll still see people carrying these up in the mountains on a wildfire every day. Last one that we use a lot is what's called a council rake. This is This is an interesting and also very old tool based on an agricultural implement. This is a basically a short section of a hay scythe used off of maybe a PTO hay cutter on a tractor. They just cut four teeth off of that, weld it to a ferrule, and stick your rake handle in there. So it's got nice sharp teeth that can be, you know, they stay sharp even if you're digging in gravel and stuff. Dig some fire line with it. They work really well in grass. They're great in woods fires like this for moving leaves. And again, ancient tool. You still see these old, you know, hay mowers sitting out in field rusting after 150 years. But this is what these are made out of, and you still see them on the fire line today.
Hi, I'm Nathan Spiegel. I'm the Burn Crew Manager with the Nature Conservancy. And I just want to talk to you for a minute about the drip torch. This is a tool we use in prescribed firework to get the fire on the ground. It's a pretty simple piece of equipment here. All of this neck folds down into the canister when not in use. There's a couple valves on here that control the flow. And generally, it's filled with a mixture of gasoline and diesel fuel. Yeah, so once you get the drip torch set up here, you got all your valves open, you can see fuel will drip out, and you just apply that to flame, and you have a wick here that stays lit the whole time, and then from there you can just, as the name implies, drip it out, or even sling it a little bit.
My name is Ben Snyder. I'm with the Illinois Department of Natural Resources, and I was just going to show you and give you a quick introduction to equipment that we use on a burn. This is my UTV that we use on prescribed fire. It's got a 50-gallon tank in the back with a pump and a hose reel that we can use to spray water on the fire if needed. On the UTV, we also have a leaf blower that we can use to put in some quick line to blow the leaves out of the way if we have a spot or the fire gets out. We've got some hand tools on here that we'll use. On the other side, we have a chainsaw that we can use for felling burning snags or trees that are on fire that need to be moved away from the line. And we also have drip torches on here that we use to ignite the fire and get things started.
There's a number of other tools that you could find utilized on a prescribed fire. Everything from backpack water sprayers to other kind of hand tools, all the way up to vehicle fire engines, or even on larger fires, the use of helicopters to help ignition. What we wanted to do was just highlight the common tools that you'll find pretty much on any prescribed fire out there.